crowd control, you know, so much early aggression that is potentially coming out here from the Xin Zhao. And this feels like this is a Flash Wolves lineup to really speed up the pace of the game. They have them with physical damage, rush the early Seekers to give you a lot of safety there.
But surprise, the bottom lane is on the top side of the map. Palette is able to land the concussive blows. The knockout comes out. Palette not able to connect, but it does force Hanabi to backstep. Now visible on the map, the exhaust coming out. One stack going to be there. Big Coral going to use the heal to get closer. Two taps. Piercingly lit there on the top side. The TP coming
in. Summon of spells, but you to try and get that kill up towards the top side
used
of the map.
In that play, nobody saw it. But now, the speed of the game is starting to ramp up as the Rift Herald has been used on the top side. A few plays picked up by PBB. Of course, the more members here, the stronger the tower will be. But still going to try to cut through it. Those first three plates quite easy, and rather just forced to back away in this trade.
Yeah, in the meantime, Xiaosi and Betty are working away at that turret. They will be the first ones to knock down a turret, grabbing that first brick for themselves. But despite the fact that Hanabi went down, this was not the most clean play here from Flash Wolves. You had to feel like running back into the Shroud with the calling active, he maybe could have just immediately flashed away, you know, had enough health to survive any potential dive, rather uses the teleport after Hanabi has already gone down instead of early.
This team is starting to put a lot more pressure on the top side.
Yeah, and the gunblade certainly, you know, is a little bit delayed, but should be okay.
Huge chunk of damage there. Zuhao definitely going to try to find the kill here, but the body block on the Prey Seeker will stop anything from going down. Xiaosi now Zero stepping forward. That's going to be Betty taken out. Huge damage coming in from the Aatrox. The Xin Zhao just deleted. Now going to walk forward. The point and click. The double kill coming through, though. In the meantime, on the bottom side, we have to get the
They have all five members here and in full control. A fight here could be risky.
TP coming in. Betty immediately going to get targeted out. They know how good his Kalista is. It's not going to get the chance to push a single button. The fight quickly going to Flash Wolves with Hanabi trying to find the execution on the backside. Rather, in the midst of everybody, a lot of AoE damage in the silence because he healed. Not enough to survive there in the midst of five on the side of PBB. All five members left standing as three go down on the side of Flash Wolves.
We talked about how this could have been risky for Flash Wolves. It was Fongbu Buffalo that had the positional advantage. And all
toe-to-toe, the Aatrox has had his number across all these fights.
I remember how we talked a lot about these compositions where
Aatrox ultimate out of Rather. He will back off, but this does mean the bot lane tower can be taken out. Zhuhao will grab the solo gold there, it looks like.
Notice how on the minimap they're keeping pushed up both the mid lane and the bot lane, which makes it pretty. Now Gol gonna face Shake Rather.
Walking the 1v1, have to respect the Rek'Sai ultimate, but so much shielding already coming in from the Ryze. Not afraid whatsoever. Zeros now gonna be on the hunt here. Hanabi waiting around. The Ryze is gonna come in as well. Dark and Blade, where's it going to go? Boogie now running, trying to make his way out of the team by Hanabi on the retreat as well. The Rek'Sai ultimate comes out. Gnoll very much in danger here. Rather trying to find the kill, but he can't. Gnoll outmaneuvering so far. Forced to use the stopwatch. Betty now chasing down the fight. He's still alive. Betty untouched on the backside. Have to respect the Aatrox, but Flash Wolves are taking over the fight. That's two shutdowns coming in. Top members may be willing to commit to the full fight, but I don't know if they have enough time to make it into this pit. 3K and dropping. The Baron should go to Flash Wolves. Can he find the Miracle Stealer? No. Xin Zhao is going to take it down. The fight breaks out. The PBE are on the back foot. Rather in trouble, but has the Aatrox ultimate available with the resurrection coming out. Xiaosi trying to make his way out to safety, but Betty now in trouble. Rek'Sai goes under, comes out. Betty goes down. Boogie next on the menu. Flash Wolves are falling apart in the fight. The contest from PBB may just save the day. Two members walking away with the Baron.
Two back to back.
It is PBB, kind of first ones to the scene, and they are going to look to turn.
Looking for the engage. Massive Braum ultimate. Lucian locked up in the backside, but immediately the coin's going to come out. Not going to connect on the Boogie, though. Able to block a little bit of the damage, but Palette and Koro in the midst of the team. Betty, no chance left to survive. Desperate to make it out of this one. Koro going to take him down. Double kill for the Lucian, but he's caught the meat grinder here. Zeros, though, going to look to fire back. The stolen Silas ultimate may not be enough to keep Rather alive. Zeros, though, desperate on the chase. The Akali invisible for now. Xiaosi going to be the sacrificial Nautilus here in the exchange.
Fight as well, because at the beginning of the game, something we talked a lot about was both teams have strong solo laners that are going to scale up to be strong split pushers. Flash weren't confident committing to the fight, but now the re-engage coming out from
Flash Forward. Vise tries to buy a bit of time as the Shroud off cooldown. Hanabi not going to use it quite yet. Immediately the re-engage. Boogie stepping in forward onto the front line, but he's just hitting the Braum. Not at all what you want. Big Koro backing off. Gnoll backing off. They're not able to hit anything. They have to be careful. They're respecting the front line of Flash Wolves. They're respecting the dive potential.
And
it just means that they're absolutely getting destroyed. Big Koro
looking to take control of this game.
And we've seen this one before. Zeros tries to step forward. Big Koro, though, now the one in trouble. Flash Wolves immediately turn. A beautiful play. The Rek'Sai coming through. Big Koro, the GA being burned. Gnoll now running for his life. They're going to focus on the AD carry. They're going to take him down. And this time around, they're not looking to sacrifice anything for that Baron.
Beautiful stuff from the Flash Wolves, taking their time, not overcommitting to the objective, and running the risk of this Ryze demolishing this team in the Baron pit. The rest of Fongbu have backed away. They realize they cannot secure this objective, and this will be the second Baron of the game going over to Flash Wolves.
A back and forth game. The gold graph tells a story. The Baron was contested at first, but a beautiful turn off from Flash Wolves. They will secure it. They will start to match
lead into a win. And they end up in this breakpoint with a lot of dancing, a lot of fighting. And Flash Wolves, they've just been steadily scaling up. They've been relying on the advantage that a Sylas and an Akali can build once those items start to come through. And now, level 18 on Hanabi, level 17 on Rather. Three items finished for both.
Double Mountain and the Infernal. Double Infernals and the Mountain. Four PvP are good for them overall, but you have to feel one more fight gets fumbled, then immediately Flash Wolves can just close the game.
Yeah, definitely.
Try here. Hanabi, though, with the TP up and available, would be there for the contest. And at this stage, the game just goes down far too quickly. Of course, Elder will be an objective to join the map quite some of the perceived stronger reaches. That said, however, rather taking away the ultimate and setting up for a fight, you can see PvP not usually possible with long extended team fights where he is able to take the Aatrox ult.
They're just
very likely.
Baron. Let's go.
TP coming in the fight. The arena has been laid down. Boogie, though, stepping on the backside. Has to be careful. Immediately, Aatrox Skulls is coming out. Pallet blocking so much damage to the backline. Unthreatened thus far. In goes Hanabi. He's trying to clear up some space. Goes golden as well. Now it's been null. It's been caught out. The rise has been isolated. The shutdown is massive. Immediately, Flash will start to take control of the fight. All eyes on Big Goro, but Bougie is buying time for the rest of his team. Pallet now running for the hills. Rather in trouble, but he has not gone down yet. The Rek'Sai ultimate stolen away. Most likely will be used to chase down Big Goro. He will fall in this fight if Rather wants to pursue. There it goes. Goes under, comes right back up. Easy kill for the side of Flash Wolves. Not only PFs on the opposite side, PvP have fallen apart.
Flash Wolves stacking up those spears on the Elder Dragon. This is going to be theirs, no problem.
Two stacks on the Elder Dragon, huge.
Baron. We'll see if PvP is going to be able to actually set anything up to turn.
We're going to Zuhao, a lot of immediate CC coming in. The GA is there, but it's not going to mean much. Zeros, will he try to go over the wall? Will they try to keep this fight going? It's going to be the pick onto the jungler. Flash Wolves move right back into that pit.
And with the jungler gone, the risk of a smite steal has diminished as well. So PvP are just forced to play on the defensive. They're going to have to hold the line against an Elder Dragon, Baron-empowered Flash Wolves, who have managed to, even though the deficit, he's been very consistent in how he's been playing the Sylas, along with
utilize the split push power that their composition have,
threaten all three waves rather than just two, but they're committed to grouping up. And they're going to look to set up this siege in the mid-tier tower now. It is slowly going down thanks to the cannon minion, and Betty's getting a couple hits off.
And you can see how hard it is for Aatrox to get damage down onto Betty. Such a tanky build, a lot of lifesteal coming in from the Kalista. Mid lane breaks, that means the inhibitor will follow. All of PvP now forced to the bottom side just to bend one more. Breaking open that single inhibitor is going to give Flash Wolves a very large for PvP to even step forward and take down this empowered cannon minion. They're using everything they have, which includes a Rek'Sai Prey Seeker. All of the Q abilities between every champion on their team just to limit that one down, but the tower will break anyway, and Flash Wolves now barreling into the base, rather waiting on that flank, as you mentioned, Azale. Trying to find an option, see if this is going to be where PvP decide to engage. It only gets harder from here. Losing a second inhibitor would be disastrous. Shaoxi, though, the member that has been picked out, Betty trying to reset the fight. Fate's call, will they keep going? Flash Wolves just going to back away. They know they have the advantage. They don't want to risk anything here.
I feel like Flash Wolves, they've been playing the fights extremely well so far. They don't need to back off.
Here we go. Hook goes in, not all Zul can hit multiple members. Hanabi immediately into the backside, goes invisible. Big Coral not able to fight comfortably. Hanabi taking down Pallet. Flash Wolves are just rolling over PvP. Absolute dominance. Hanabi put down in the early game, but getting his vengeance in this final fight. Flash Wolves now poised to end the game. Slow and controlled, they found a way back. The triple kill for the Akali. Zeros doing what he can to survive, but it will not matter. Flash Wolves find their first win.
Big pickup for the Flash Wolves.